Okay, now, when Take That split up in 1996, thousands and thousands of fans were left brokenhearted. And mothers and daughters...
Oh, they were.
Mothers and daughters everywhere had to face up to life without these boys.
Oh, it brings a tear to my eye, Mark.
And me too.
Oh, I remember that
day.
Yeah, Mark Evans here, morning.
Hey, hello, Mark.
Good morning, how are you guys?
Nice to see you, nice to see you.
Great to be here.
When you reflect on those days, when you look at that video, what do you think? Do you look at it with affection?
Yeah, I suppose so, you know. I'm kind of proud of what we achieved as a pop band. But I think that now when I see myself kind of doing all that dancing in the little vest and things, you know.
And thongs.
And the thongs. We had some great thongs back in the day.
You did. I remember, didn't you do the sort of devil outfits with a big red thong? I seem to remember.
A small thong. It wasn't that big, actually. But, yeah, we had chaps and we had some great outfits. But I don't wear them so much anymore, to be honest.
Oh, come on, you must do around the house.
Only in the bedroom, yeah, now and again. it's funny because whenever I go to, like, weddings, that song always gets played. You know, if you go on the dance floor, your auntie's and uncle's wedding party, the DJ decides, if you ever step on the dance floor, to put that song on. Right. And you get this big circle around you of people all going, go, and you're like,
no.
I don't do it anymore, you
really?
Know?
Can you remember the choreography, though?
No, I can't really. Really? I remember there was some little move left to right in that song that was kind of the one move that I could remember, but the rest of it I wouldn't really know.
It's really real, sort of proper good pop. Your sound now is completely different. Did you feel uncomfortable doing that style of music at the time? Were you listening to sort of other bands?
Yeah, I was listening to other bands. I always say that, in a sense, Tate, that was like being at college or university. It was a bit like a school for me, you know. I went into that band maybe listening to Boys to Men and stuff like that, and came out listening to Paul Weller and, you know, Radiohead. And so I bought my first keyboard while I was in the band, and I wrote my first song. My first song was a song called Sensuality, which I'm thankfully to say has never seen the light of day. It got stolen when I was on holiday in Greece once. Somebody broke into my room and stole the tape, and I was glad about that. It was a terrible song.
Was it? Yes. Was it a slow one?
It was a bit like TLC kind of mold, but nothing like TLC were great. But
can you remember the lyrics?
No, it was just sensuality and probably about getting down and lifting your vest up and wearing thongs.
Really? Well, it's interesting, there was a show on Channel 4 last night which was called something like Britney's Redneck Roots.
I watched it.
I thought it was great.
It was brilliant.
And they were talking about the rise of Britney and people like Britney, and they were saying, actually, it was because of the success of Take That and the Spice Girls that people like Britney actually happened. So you've got a lot to answer for.
Yes, I heard him say, I watched it.
Did
as well.
You? Wasn't
yeah,
that interesting?
I heard him saying that.
Yeah.
You know, it's funny, when we were together as a band, we went over to America. We had a hit over there with Back for Good. But we went over there as an almost complete different band. You know, we Gary sat down at the piano, Jason was on guitar, and they thought we was a band more in that kind of mould. And then we split up after that, after we had a top five in America. But I remember Clive Davis, who was this big American kind of... I don't know what you call them, like a master.
Big cheese
in America. He came over and saw us when we were doing Earl's Court. We did 10 nights at Earl's Court. And he came over and we all went over to his hotel afterwards, and he was saying, this kind of thing will never work in America. And then about a year later, obviously, they had like the Backstreet and NSYNC.
Yeah, exactly.
I'm kind of glad we never... I mean, we had a hit there with Back for Good, but I'm glad that we kind of split up when
after you did split up, what was it like then? Because suddenly to be so busy and touring and being with the lads, did it kind of hit you hard?
No, because I went straight into writing. I went into the studio with John Leckie and made my first album, which was Green Man, you know. So that kind of came about straight away. And since then, I've been doing my own solo stuff. I'm on my third album now.
Right. And we're going to have to go through the news, but it's Believe in the Boogie, your singer's creating a lot of heat, and we're going to hear Believe in the Boogie live a bit later, back in a couple of minutes.